So I'm currently using the Oppo F11 Pro. It has my SIM, it has my Instagram accounts, and basically it's my daily driver. But I had really good thoughts about the iPhone 11, so I thought why not share with you. So this video is for those who are thinking to buy an iPhone in 2020, obviously after the lockdown, but yes, if they are thinking to buy an iPhone, then I think you should definitely consider the iPhone 11 over the new iPhone SE. Why I say that? Because Apple has really disappointed its users with the release of iPhone SE. From the old days to now, Apple has been known for making innovative designs, making some of the changes which other companies don't ever think of. But this time Apple has really disappointed its users as it has decreased the size of the screen, which is something not acceptable in 2020. And it's not only about the screen as well. It's about the price. It's a 42,000 rupees phone with specs of an old iPhone. In that much of amount, you can get an OnePlus 8, which is brand new, has great specs, and follows the trend as well. Some of you may also say that they are giving the A13 Bionic chipset in iPhone SE, but you can easily spend a 64,000 rupees on iPhone 11. Which is giving you a best camera, a best screen, and the same chipset. There's no use of spending a 42,000 rupees on iPhone SE in 2020 when you have better options available in the market. Some of you may also say that it's very easy for me to say that you can easily spend a 64,000 rupees on iPhone 11. But yes, if you have 42,000 rupees to spend on an iPhone that is just giving you the latest processor and depriving you on screen, then I would surely say that you can wait until you get that much of amount to buy an iPhone 11, which is better than iPhone SE. So Apple, what were you thinking? You're gonna fool your customers by saying that iPhone SE is the best budget iPhone and you're gonna sell them iPhone 8 with iPhone 11 specs? That what you're thinking? It's not gonna happen. Okay, so for me, buying an iPhone is a luxury. It's a dream come true. I used to use the iPhone 5S before I bought the Oppo F11 Pro. So everyone thinks that whenever they are buying an iPhone or thinking to buy an iPhone, that their iPhone should be the best. It should be with best specs, best camera, best processor. But with iPhone SE, it's not that case. Okay, so now forget the iPhone SE and let's talk about the iPhone 11. Okay guys, so I think that iPhone 11 is the best iPhone ever made by Apple after iPhone 10. It has the best camera setup, it has a 12 plus 12 megapixel dual rear camera and a 12 megapixel front camera. It has a 6.1 inches liquid retina display with IP68 rating, which makes it water resistant up to 2 meters for 30 minutes. This phone features an ultra wide and a wide camera and supports 4K recording at 60fps. Here are some camera samples shot from the iPhone 11. When it comes to performing, this phone is a performing beast since it has the A13 Bionic chipset, which is the fastest for any iPhone. The phone used in this video is a 64GB variant of this iPhone, but this iPhone also comes in 128GB and a 256GB variant. The screen resolution of the iPhone 11 is 1792 into 868 pixels. The iPhone 11 comes in 6 different colors for you to choose. They are black, purple, white, red, yellow, and green. Personally, I like the black color variant. The EMI for iPhone 11 starts at 2,335 rupees per month on Flipkart, and you have other easy payment options as well. Okay guys, if you don't want to escape the Apple's ecosystem and you want an iPhone, then you should definitely go for the iPhone 11 instead of the iPhone SE. And you can also have a look at the Androids ranging as well, as they have a lot to offer in specs and with a considerable pricing. Okay guys, with that being said, we come to the end of this video. I hope you have liked this video. If you have liked this video, then do consider hitting that bell icon and subscribing to this channel for never missing update from my channel. Hit the like button or hit the dislike button if you don't like this video, and please comment down below what do you think about the iPhone SE and the iPhone 11 comparison. Thank you for watching, and I would see you in my next video. Till then, peace.